We flying to the Mara today with the Dash 7. We have four stops, four destinations, and we're checking the weather for the route to the Mara and the winds, so we can choose the level we want to fly to. We also check the passenger manifest and routing that operation and reservation has put together for us. And after that, we check the loads so that we're able to transfer these loads and do the appropriate load sheets for the different stops in the Mara.
So we're going to start the pre-flight, the outside walk around, and check for all the items that need to be checked on this Dash 7. Alright, so we'll start on the left main gear. Check the condition of the brake lines, brake linings. There's some indicators inside the wheel there. Make sure that all that is good. Tires are in good condition. We usually get damage from the rocks in the field. These look quite new. Under the wing, one of the Achilles heel of this aircraft is the hydraulic system, so we always check very carefully for possible leaks. In this case, looks all good. This is why we also leave the flaps out, so we can inspect these items. Okay, good.
Well, this is a Dash 7 100 series, and it's a very conventional cockpit. We don't have any EFIs in here, just standard instrument, mechanical. Being a stall aircraft, we have flight spoilers and ground spoilers. Spoilers that will actually aid turning the aircraft, banking the aircraft at low speeds to make it more efficient. Very much an hydraulic airplane, so we have two big gauges indicating the hydraulic quantities for the left and right system. And underneath we have the number one and two system hydraulic pressures and the brake pressure, which is now indicating at nearly 3000 psi. That's what we need to have effective brakes. The hydraulic pressure, of course, they're down because there are no hydraulic pumps working now, the engines are shut down.
Used to be, not anymore though.
Clamps?
15.
Landing gear?
Down 3 green.
Lights are on, sink is off cabin.
Secure.
Okay, flaps and props to go.
There's the lodge, Keycroft Lodge, in those trees there, so it's pretty close to the runway. There used to be a taxiway, you could go all the way to the lodge by plane. Right, flaps 25.
Speed check.
And props full fine.
This complete VRF is 78 knots. Runway looks clear. And wind looks like.
Approaching 40 knots.
Right, control locks on. Flaps 15 after landing checklists. And feather 2 and 3.
2 and 3.
The main threat for us here is the birds. We've had quite a few over the years, bird strikes. So we've got a limited speed at this kind of altitude of 150 knots. We could go quite a bit faster, but 150 knots we feel would give us a bit more time to react, also probably a bit less damage in case we hit something. yesterday.
Yeah. Okay. Flight controls.
Checked.
Before takeoff flow.
Complete.
Cabin.
Cabin. On a roll.
Likewise now rolling 27. Keep off flow.
Alright, set takeoff power.
Takeoff power set. 60 knots.
60 knots.
V1 rotate. Positive brake.
Gear up.
Looking for 89 flap 15.
Flaps 15.
Speed check. Looking for 98 flaps up.
Flaps up.
Speed check.
Just showing up.
Flaps.
25.
Okay, props are full fine. And flap full
flaps. One left base, 341.
Full flaps.
Speed check.
Cockpit on AG, left base, 34.
Runway looks clear. Wind
yeah.
Calm. Final,
the 34. Oh, okay. We had another gear brake with the one hook off. Another gear brake. We landed in Sarandi Harbor.
Action. Flights in the cockpit. You're invited. Available on Blu-ray and DVD in our webshop at www.vikingaviationphoto.com.